Hi, it's Ife Chuksadizue of ShareVirtuosity.com. You're welcome to another episode of The Uncommon Woman Show, the place to be, to birth and become the woman of your dreams, that woman that God had in mind when He created you. Today we have another interesting topic. The question is, how do I become successful in life? Now, for a platform or for a ministry that is focused on raising women of success, uncommon women of success, this question actually resonated deeply with me. So today I'll be sharing with you 7 tips on how to become successful in life. Ready? Cool. Tip number 1, you need to define success. Success is a word that means different things to different people. But it's important for you to understand that success is when a person, a thing, accomplishes its purpose. So for you to define success, you need to be clear on what your purpose is. What's your purpose as a woman? What's your purpose as an individual? You need to list out all these things and define success for yourself. Have a success statement. The second tip is you need to find a reference point or a reference. Who is that person that is living this your dream life today? Who is that person whose everyday reality today is what you desire? And what can you learn from that person? 3. You need to ascertain where you are today. You need to assess yourself all around. You can never move and grow into a particular person without understanding who you are today, at what level are you today, what are the key strengths that you have, what are the areas that you need to improve on. So you need to run an assessment of yourself to understand where you are today. We actually have a worksheet that can help you do this. It's a life assessment sheet. The link to access it is below and it's free, so it's a gift from me. 4, you need to do a gap analysis. You need to understand, now that you know what success is, what you define success as, you found the reference and you're pulling out things from that person that you can apply into your life, you are also clear on where you are today. The next big question is, what are the gaps that I see today? What are the gaps that I need to close out? What knowledge do I need to become this person of my dreams? What skills do I need to become the person of my dreams? What attitudes do I need to learn? Do I need to imbibe? And do I need to make it part of my life to become the person of my dreams? So that's your gap analysis. 5, you need to create an action plan. If you don't plan, that means you are looking to failing. So if you fail to plan, it means you're planning to fail. You can have all the gap analysis. You can have the most amazing reference or mentor. You can have a list of things that you're going to learn. And without an action plan, all those things are wasted effort. So here you need to create an action plan. Have a plan for your life. For the next 1 year, what are the key things I want to achieve? Now go beyond that. What are the exact actions I am going to take to be able to become this person or do this? How would I measure success at the end of the day? By what timings do I want to achieve each of these things? When you've done that for a year, you break it down into a quarter. So for example, January, February, March, out of your annual plan or your annual goals list, what do I want to achieve in this quarter? What are the times that I'm working with? How would I measure success? So the important thing about step number 5 is that you need to come out with an action plan that is detailed enough, that shows what you need to do, by what timings you need to do them, and how you would know if you were successful, how would you measure success. 6, you need to execute. You need to execute, you need to work, you need to get into the trenches. You've had the plan, you've created the plan, you put it up, it looks all pretty on your wall, or it looks all nice and dolled up in your Excel sheet. If you don't do anything about it, then it remains a plan. If you've come as far as creating a plan, then you need to get yourself up and actually work. What are the different things you plan to do? As much as possible, don't have more than 10 action points as a total. This allows you to work gradually, but you need to execute. And lastly, point number 7, you need to track and celebrate your success. One thing I found that makes it easy for us to track is when you have an accountability partner. An accountability partner can be your friend, can be your spouse, it can be someone, you know, around you. But it's important that your accountability partner is someone that you respect, someone that you can't give bullshit to. someone that, you know, if he asks you, you know that you're going to have to review with that person. And so you really want to get everything done before you go and meet the person. So you get an accountability partner, and with this person, you track your successes. And please, by all means, celebrate your little successes. Don't wait for that big grand one before you start to celebrate. If you plan in a week to create or to write the first chapter of your book, for example, and you did that, please spoil yourself. You know, treat yourself. That's celebrating the small successes. With not within any a short time, you would have done the big goal and closed it out. So that's it for today. 7 points or 7 tips to guide you to become successful in this life. So now that you have all this information, what are you going to do differently? Anyway, I trust you to use them and bring out something beautiful out of them. Remember, there's an assignment with your name on it. There's a world out there just waiting for your touch. And there's a God in heaven that is just waiting to back you up. So you need to get your game face on and arise and shine brightly. If you liked this video, please click like, share with your friends and family, and click the bell button to subscribe to more updates from us.